now on Coast TV News.
Another beautiful day on the way to the coast. I'll have your picture perfect fall forecast coming up in just a moment.
Limiting sea level rise is available to Milton and dealing with the water from the Broadkill River.
Second chance for Stillwater after it was denied in the summer. The proposed housing development in Oak Orchard gets another review.
Another whack at weed. We look at the latest coastal community attempting to ban recreational marijuana.
This is Coast TV News Today.
And welcome to our 6 o'clock hour. Good morning. I'm Matt Pensick.
Good morning. I'm Paige Marley. It is Tuesday, November 7th, 2023.
You know, Alex said this earlier this morning, and it was like one of those whoa moments.
Yeah.
But we're basically 2 weeks away from Thanksgiving.
There's another holiday that's 2 weeks away. Do you remember?
I do. Actually, 2 weeks from tomorrow.
Is it really?
Isn't it?
I think so. You're right.
Your birthday.
My
We're talking
birthday.
About her birthday,
yeah.
folks.
We're just messing around. Not a holiday.
I still have to buy some stuff for you.
Oh, yeah. You don't have to get me anything.
Oh, yes, I do.
Oh, I insist then. It's fine. Well, let's bring in First Alert meteorologist Alex Seymour. Alex, you don't have to get me a birthday present either. It's okay.
All right. Maybe cake.
Perfect.
All right, so we've got some gorgeous weather on the way for today. Certainly doesn't feel like it's 2 weeks away from Thanksgiving when you step outside, especially as we head towards this afternoon. We're going to be climbing up into the 70s, and this morning really doesn't feel like a November morning. Dry Tech camera at the Ember Center in Ocean City. It is a quiet start to the day. Temps sitting at 54 degrees in Ocean City. It is a little breezy in Ocean City. South winds at 16 miles per hour, but other then if you're right along those back bays, most locations are actually seeing some rather light winds. Temps in Ocean City going to climb up into the mid to upper 60s later on today. Other locations, we're climbing into the 70s. Right now, temps all across the region, 50s and 60s. We're seeing winds, most locations, 5 miles per hour or less. Skies, they're slowly clearing out. We were seeing thick cloud cover all across Delmarva just a few hours ago. Now it's thinning out. We're seeing those breaks, and we're going to continue to see those breaks open up throughout the morning hour. So our bus stop forecast for this morning down to 56 degrees, but still not a bad start to the day for early November. And then this afternoon, take a look at that, climbing up to 75 degrees. So shorts and short sleeve shirts, probably a good idea for today.
Sounds great, Alex. Thank you. Sea level rise is a common topic in towns along the coastline. Now the town of Milton is exploring what can be done to combat sea level rise in the Broadkill River. For those who don't know, the Broadkill River that goes through Milton is a tidal river. Now the town council accepted a report on how sea level rise could impact the town in the future. Some of the places that were identified were the library, Memorial Park, and the theater as well. The Milton Theater says they've already taken steps to protect the theater for years to come.
Even if it's 50 years from now or 100 years from now, I mean, we definitely want the theater to be here for, you know, even when we're long gone, so that it, you know, it stays as a venue for future generations.
Even though the town council accepted the report, there was consensus that there is still a lot of work to be done to prepare for the future.
Happening today, Sussex County Council can make a call on the appeal to a proposed development in Oak Orchard. The 57-acre, 120-home development was originally denied by Sussex County Planning Commission back in June, but the developer's attorney appealed to the council 2 weeks ago, saying the project will actually curb flooding in the area and help address the high demand for housing in Sussex County. This is listed at the top of the agenda at this morning's meeting scheduled for 10 a.m.
The next coastal town to discuss marijuana is South Bethany. It's having its second marijuana meeting this week. The town says it will readdress the recreational marijuana business and sale ban ordinance. At its last meeting, no action was taken and no public comment was held. This meeting is taking place on November 9th at 9 a.m.
Developing news in Millsboro, work is underway for the construction of a new police station. This will be on Railroad Avenue in Ellis Street. The new station will be about 13,000 square feet, more than doubles the size of the current station. And it will feature separate offices for different departments, a private office for its victim services advocate, larger officers' quarters, and more. Police Chief Ryan Calloway says he hopes the new building inspires those interested in joining the department.
First, I hope it gets people engaged to want to serve their community. That's what the purpose of law enforcement is. So I hope that there are some new faces, maybe someone that's in the military, someone that's at college right now, that's looking to go to an upcoming police department that is growing, a town is growing, a town that's supportive, and they'll choose us.
Chief Calloway says he expects the department to move into the new station on January 1st of 2024.
City of Rehoboth Beach has hired its first city planner, Mary Ellen Gray. Gray started working with the city on October 23rd, and according to Rehoboth Beach, she is now overseeing the management of development plans for buildings, working with the Public Works Department for the planning of utilities for future development, and more. Polls in Salisbury, they open in just less than 2 hours. On the ballot, candidates for mayor and city council. Three are attempting to become the city's next mayor. That's Megan Outen, Jermichael Mitchell, and Randy Taylor. Also up for election are four of Salisbury's five council seats. Those polls in Salisbury, they open today at 7 a.m. and they'll be open until 7 p.m.
And across the nation, other races will be decided. This is a bit of a warm-up for what is expected to be, Paige, a contentious 2024 election.
Definitely. Some political analysts, they figure key races in 2023 could foreshadow what lies ahead. John Lawrence shows us some of the big topics on the ballot in some states, as well as what offices are up for grabs.
Election Day 2023 features a few statewide races for elective offices, and some cities are electing mayors. Relatively low-key. But that doesn't mean this Tuesday should be glossed over. In Ohio, residents will determine two ballot measures, one that would create a law legalizing marijuana and the other that would enshrine the right to abortion in the Buckeye State's constitution.
There have been six abortion rights ballot measures that have taken place since the Dobbs decision, and in each case, the abortion rights side won in those, so Ohio would be the seventh, which to me is an indication of how popular abortion rights are in this country.
Over in Kentucky, Democratic Governor Andy Beshear is running for re-election against GOP challenger Attorney General Daniel Cameron.
It's a very red state that has only elected, I believe, three Republican governors in the last, like, 75 years.
And then there's Virginia, where voters will decide the balance of power for both chambers of state government.
Historically speaking, the party that wins the state Senate, at least the last few cycles, has done very, very well in the next year's presidential race.
Speaking of 2024, polling from the New York Times and Siena College shows former President Donald Trump is leading President Joe Biden in four swing states: Arizona, Georgia, Michigan, and Nevada. I'm John Lawrence reporting.
Trump, despite his legal challenges, is the Republican Party's frontrunner in 2024. Biden, as most incumbents, is considered the Democrat Party's frontrunner, although Minnesota Representative Dean Phillips, he's hoping to bump the president off the ticket.
New polling from the New York Times shows President Biden falling just behind former President Trump in some key swing states. The president trailing Trump in five of the six battleground states that helped him win the election in 2020. Biden is right now behind in Nevada, Georgia, Arizona, Michigan, and Pennsylvania. He's only ahead in Wisconsin. Trump's ongoing criminal cases may be a major factor, though. The poll found roughly 6% of voters across Arizona, Georgia, Nevada, Pennsylvania, and Wisconsin would switch from Trump to Biden if Trump is convicted. That's a big enough swing to ensure Biden's re-election.
And this brings us to our Coast TV poll. We want to know if you think President Biden will win re-election.
All right, let's take a look at these updated results from our last hour. 52% of you say no, he will not win re-election. 46% of you say yes, he will. Just 2% saying it's a little too early for you to vote. That's fine. It's still very close there. Still, though, the majority stayed the same of 52% saying no. You can still vote. Go to CoastTVNews.com. or our mobile app. We'll show you some updated results later on today. Well, crews worked to clean up vandalized gates at the White House following a weekend of protests. Some pro-Palestinian attendees opted to damage buildings and vandalize White House gates there. Protesters laced statues and gates with anti-Semitic graffiti as they marched toward the White House, demanding a ceasefire in Gaza. Some even tried to climb the White House gate.
Still more to get to in this hour of Coast TV News Today.
Coming up, DART began its Stuff the Bus food drive this week. What one person says about why food drives like this are especially important near the holidays.
Also, Delaware Back Bay study, it's been put on hold. Why some people say this study is necessary.
And some people may be experiencing a delay in receiving direct deposits due to an issue last week. What caused the delay and what banks are now saying about your funds? All that and more when Coast TV News Today continues.
We're dealing with some twisted psychopath.
I want to help.
I am going to find your son.
He's a kidnapper no one would think to look for.
How do you know this?
You're hiding something from me.
Found tonight on NBC.
NBC and streaming on Peacock.
NBC News hosts the Republican presidential debate, moderated by Lester Holt and Kristen Welker. Joined by Hugh Hewitt, how would the candidates confront the critical challenges at home and abroad as the next commander-in-chief? Wednesday at 8 p.m.
Fall into planting at Bella Terrace Garden Center. Autumn is the perfect time of year for planting. Come check out our locally sourced collection of trees and shrubs of all shapes and sizes. Did you know? Bella Terra is open 7 days a week. Join our garden club for big savings and first access to all sale promotions. Stocked with the smallest of succulents to the tallest of trees, Bella Terra's Garden Center here for all your gardening needs. Like us on Facebook and follow us on Instagram, located right off of Route 16 in Ellendale.
You have the power to leave the world a little better than you found it. You have the power to live a more carefree life. You have the power to make your home more energy efficient and less costly to operate. Solar from Clean Energy USA can give you that power. With over 14 years of experience and thousands of systems installed, solar power is more attainable than ever, with generous incentives making it less costly than you may think. Contact Clean Energy USA today to get your power.
JoJo's in Salisbury serves fresh, homemade food in an upscale, family-friendly atmosphere. Enjoy delicious crab dishes like our colossal lump crab cakes or our creamy crab dip served in a fresh baked bread bowl and the best cream of crab soup in town. Try the new pineapple blast or wind down with our wine selection, beer on tap, and other cocktails. Have an event? Reserve your private suite or banquet room today. JoJo's Family Restaurant, where family dines together and dinner tastes better.
Good morning, Delmarva. Well, we're seeing a pretty mild start to the day. You probably don't even need that heavy jacket, and maybe not even a light jacket this morning, as temps are in the 50s to close to 60 degrees this morning. Those temps just going to continue to rise. We've got southerly winds really pumping in that warmer air across the region. Clouds, they are starting to fall apart, so we're just going to continue to see improvements throughout the daytime hours. Our pickleball forecast for today, take a look at that, starting out in the 60s, climbing up into the mid-70s this afternoon, so absolutely gorgeous conditions.
All right, we got news from Milford. The city's Parks and Recreation Department will have a ribbon-cutting ceremony. Speaking of pickleball, this will be for those new pickleball courts and playground in Memorial Park. Park is located along the Riverwalk. This is east of South Washington Street. It's near the basketball court. The ribbon cutting is expected to be held later this week on Thursday at 2 p.m. in front of the playground. Milford officials say the public is invited to attend. In Delaware, the school choice application window is now open for families. These are some important dates parents should keep in mind when applying. The online school choice application, it'll close January 10th. Just before midnight, 11:59 p.m. Final day for the district and school to notify parents of invitation status sets on February 29th. And the final day for parents to notify the district and school of the acceptance decision is March 15th. According to School Choice DE, charter schools, vocational technical school districts, and magnet schools, they continue to accept applications after January 10th to fill the remaining availability.
Some bank customers still have not received their direct deposit paychecks after a human error in America's banking system last week. The deposit delays are linked to a problem that emerged Friday with the automated clearinghouse payment system, causing headaches for consumers and employers. The payments that did not go through had to be resent and a process that can take time. The clearinghouse said it's working with banks and the Federal Reserve to resolve this issue as quickly as possible. Starbucks employees are getting a pay raise next year. The company announced that non-union employees will receive at least a 3% pay bump starting January 1st. Non-union employees will also be eligible to accrue more vacation time sooner. Now, as far as unionized employees, they will get whatever pay raises they locked in last year, which those vary. They'll also will not be eligible for any vacation benefits. Still to come this morning, the Delaware Back Bay study no longer will happen when expected. What officials say is the benefit to putting a pause on the study and what you can do to help in the meantime.
Well, temps will go on a bit of a roller coaster ride this week. I'll have your forecast for all those fall activities coming up just after the break.
Get in gear with Coast Country 103.9 and 106.3.
It's Free Truck Fridays, your ticket to a new 2023 Ford Ranger, thanks to Pohanka Ford of Salisbury. Stay tuned to Big D and Bubba all week as they reveal the Free Truck Friday song.
Then listen to April and me to play the song, be caller 10, and you might be parking a new 2023 Ford Ranger in your driveway.
Drive over to CoastCountry.com for all the details.
Coast Country's Free Truck Fridays with Pohanka Ford of Salisbury,
where your drive to work
could upgrade your ride home.
When it's your home, we know you always want the best. And if it's unique, stylish, and custom made, Superior Screen and Glass is your place. We are dedicated to providing the highest quality craftsmanship to our clients on every project. With our Pella and Anderson certified windows and doors, we will help highlight the beauty and function of your home with energy efficient, protective glass. To make your business or home superior and beautiful, trust the experience and expertise of Superior Screen and Glass.
Not everyone wants a big funeral. For those seeking a simple alternative, the Eastern Shore's most trusted family and funeral service offers another option. Eastern Shore Cremation and Funeral Service is simple and affordable. A direct cremation tribute starts at just $15.95, or choose to have a small visitation service, serving Delaware, Maryland, and Virginia with easy consultation by phone and streamlined electronic documentation. Learn more at easternshorecremation.com. Eastern Shore Cremation and Funeral Services, simply respectful.
The weather is brought to you by Spicer Brothers Construction. Born here to serve here.
It is 6:16 on your Tuesday. That is a live look at Ocean City on our Dry Tech Cam. See a lot more than we normally can see right now, so happy for us there. But not a lot of action going on there in Ocean City. Pretty calm morning. Maybe a good day to go for a walk.
Yeah, water looks pretty calm there right now. And Alex mentioned those fall activities. One thing I like to do is to break out the fire pit. And it looks like we're in a good stretch of weather, Alex, to do those, some of those evening things, where you have the fire pit, maybe a beverage or some s'mores, something like that.
Yeah, certainly going to be some fantastic weather to break out the fire pit, do some bonfires across Delmarva over the really a pretty extended stretch. Yes, we may see some showers on Friday, but even then, it's going to be mainly during the morning or midday hour, so the evening hours we dry out. So we've got dry conditions, we've got light winds, so we're not really worried about those embers being blown away and maybe starting some wildfires across Delmarva, since we are getting into that dry season. But it looks like it's going to be pretty decent weather overall. Right now, Gateway Subaru Camera at the Commander Hotel in Ocean City. It is an absolutely gorgeous start. We are seeing some breaks in those clouds, some clear skies out there this morning. Still pretty quiet on the boardwalk, but I'm sure that's going to change as we progress throughout the daytime hours as we climb into the 70s later on. Right now, though, it's 54 degrees in Ocean City. Temps all across Delmarva in the 50s to close to 60 degrees. We're sitting at 60 in Bethany Beach. It's 59 in Rehoboth Beach, 59 in Lewis, 56 in Milton, 56 in Georgetown, 57 degrees in Delmar this morning. Those winds rather light, a little bit breezy right on those back bays. So the Rehoboth Bay, the Indian River Bay, the Assawoman Bay, the Little Assawoman Bay, you're going to be dealing with southwest winds, 10, 15 miles per hour. Elsewhere, 5 miles per hour or less, maybe as high as 10 miles per hour. But even as we progress throughout the day, those winds are going to decrease even along those back bays. Cloud cover wise, well, we saw quite a few clouds earlier today, earlier this morning. Those have thinned out. We're seeing those clouds break apart, and that is going to continue to be the case as we progress throughout the morning hour. So we're going to see mainly sunny skies later on today. There is a cold front off toward northwest. That is going to move through overnight tonight. Not going to bring us any rain. It's a pretty dry cold front, but what it will bring is a drop in those temps tomorrow. Briefly, very briefly, because we're going to be back in the mid-70s as we head towards Thursday. Our future guests, lots of sunshine this afternoon. Temps in the 60s, low 70s at the beaches. Mid-70s, inland, absolutely gorgeous. Get outside and enjoy that fantastic weather. As we head towards Wednesday morning, once that cold front moves through, those winds turn around to more out of the north. That's going to cool us off quite a bit as we head towards tomorrow morning, about 10 to 15 degrees cooler than what we're seeing this morning. So you're going to want to grab that light jacket as temps fall down into the 40s. And then tomorrow afternoon, probably keep that light jacket handy. Winds going to be light, so that's not going to be an issue. We're going to see lots of sunshine, but temperature-wise, it will be a little cool, staying in the 50s to close to 60 degrees. We're back with those temps in the 50s as we head towards Thursday morning. Winds start to turn out of the south, and we really start to warm up back into the mid-70s by Thursday afternoon. Our Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling 7-day forecast, and we're going to see up and down temps from 75 to 60, back up to 75, and then down into the 50s as we head into the weekend. We do have a little bit of wet weather on the way for Friday, so you're going to need that umbrella. This morning's umbrella giveaway winner is John Hudson from Seaford, Delaware. Congratulations.
A study addressing coastal storm risk is now put on hold. The Delaware Back Bay study was being conducted by DENREC and the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. According to the Army Corps, the study is too expensive and too technically challenging to continue. People in Bethany Beach say that flooding impacts their everyday life.
It happens all the time, and honestly, it deviates, you know, people getting into their homes, people getting into their businesses. Just like normal flow of traffic, like half a town of Bethany will be closed off, blocked off, and you can't even get to anywhere.
And the agencies conducting this study say a pause will help reevaluate the best course of action moving forward. The Army Corps and DENREC may pursue some joint funding opportunities. In the meantime, Bethany Beach says they're asking people to send in feedback asking for that study to happen.
Well, coming up, DART began its annual Suck the Bus holiday food drive this week. How you can catch that ride? Give back to local people in need. Stay with us on Coast TV News Today.
Take your favorite radio station with you wherever you go. Download free today.
Rekindle your romance with Draper Media Radio. Solve the password to the Poconos and you could win a weekend getaway for two. Get all the rules and details at these stations' websites and be sure to tune in to any of these Draper Media Radio stations to win.
Bed bugs will reside in your home where you fall asleep, be it your bed, a recliner, or a couch. They know there's a blood meal there, and they will have it. Heat is by far the most effective way to kill bed bugs.
It's proven scientific fact that the heat and treat program is 95% effective. After a heat and treat service, you can re-enter your residential commercial property immediately. It's a green service.
And that's important to most people.
At Bennett Termite, we wouldn't recommend this process unless we believed in it.
And we do.
Have you dry-teched yet? Just call our office to request a prompt appointment. Our engineers are not salespeople. They assess your crawl space, photograph it, prescribe a custom solution, and send you your estimate the next business day, guaranteed, along with our price match guarantee and our done right guarantee. If your crawl space doesn't stay dry, Dry-Tech will fix it for free. Right now, you can Dry-Tech your home with 0% financing for 2 years. Dry-Tech, Delmarva's original crawl space expert.
Delmarva Home Show. Explore the hidden house gems here on the peninsula. Exciting tours of stunning homes, charming cottages, and luxurious beachfront properties. Designer ideas and insider tips to help inspire your home decor. Discover the best of Delmarva's architecture and interior design. A showcase of the most unique and beautiful homes on Delmarva. Start your tour Sunday mornings at 11:30 on WBOC.
In sunshine or storms, our promise is to guide, inform, and protect. Coast TV and the First Alert Weather Team, your safety, our commitment.
This week, DART began its Stuff the Bus event, and the Food Bank of Delaware held its first drive-through pantry for the holiday season. The DART event will collect donations that will help fill shelves at local pantries, including the food bank. According to the Food Bank of Delaware, that mobile pantry alone distributed enough food for 1,500 households. About 60 volunteers are needed to hand out 3 truckfuls of groceries. It's a resource that becomes even more necessary during the holiday season.
We got a turkey, which is great because that's always one of the hardest to get. It's hard for a lot of people to be able to afford everything that they need. So this really does help out a lot.
Donations for Stuff the Bus will be collected today at the Milford Walmart from 9 a.m. until 4 p.m.
Next, the food bank will host its first ever high-stakes harvest later this month to showcase local foods. Now, this event will be held Tuesday, November 28th from 5:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. This will be at the Bones Restaurant and Lounge at Harrington Raceway and Casino. Proceeds from the evening will benefit the building of the new food bank facility in Milford.
And the town of Millville, they're planning to work with the Food Bank of Delaware to host a holiday food drive. The town, they're saying that items that are needed are stuffing mix, canned fruits and vegetables, instant potatoes, cranberry sauce, and more. There is a donation box inside Town Hall to drop off those non-perishable food items. That drive starts on November 13th. It'll run through December 8th.
All right, and as we bring back First Alert meteorologist Alex Seymour, we've been talking about it all morning, but it's just going to be a nice warm day. We can already see those temperatures starting to rise as we've been on the air.
Yeah, certainly have already started to see those temps rise. And yeah, we've got an absolutely gorgeous day on the way to the coast. Certainly not going to feel like November as you head out the door, especially as you head towards this afternoon. Temps this morning, they're pretty mild. Our average high, low 60s. We're already sitting at 60 in Bethany Beach. It's 59 in Rehoboth Beach, 56 degrees in Georgetown. Winds rather light, but coming out of the south, so that's pulling in that warmer air. Cloud cover-wise, it was thinning out. We're going to be enjoying lots of sunshine later on today. So our dog walking forecast for this morning, we're starting out in the upper 50s, close to 60 degrees, climbing up to 70 by 11 a.m. Gorgeous weather. It's dry. Get your dog out for a nice long walk. I did yesterday. Certainly enjoyed it. It's going to be even nicer today with those temps climbing into the 70s this afternoon.
Sounds good, Alex. Thank you. After the break on Coast TV News Today, yesterday, President Biden met with Amtrak workers in Newcastle County. How many different projects he says taxpayer money could help fund?
Also, possible decision on a proposed development in Oak Orchard. Our developers say these proposed addresses concerns brought by locals and officials.
And Milton aims to address sea level rise in town before it's too late. What was decided after a meeting with town officials last night? Coast TV News Today will be right back.
Farmers are superheroes, true conservationists. We are using soil health practices to help fight climate change. Soil health farmers are working today to protect tomorrow, using regenerative agriculture and climate-smart practices like no-till and cover crops to improve soil health. Healthy soils sequester carbon, improve water quality, and produce sustainable, nutrient-rich food. Soil health farmers are working today to keep Delmarva a beautiful place for generations to come.
Got what it takes to be the ultimate survivor?
Go!
Then apply for the adventure of a lifetime. Join WBOC for a Survivor open casting call Friday, November 10th at Warwick Community College in Salisbury. Go to WBOC.com for details. Middays with me, April Brilliant. It's a feel-good show on your radio.
April is the easiest way to get through your workday.
She can play your favorite song.
She can help you find your furry friend.
The easiest way to get through your workday is with April.
She really makes you feel special.
Hey friends, hang out with me weekdays here on Coast Country 103.9 and 106.3 each day from 10 to 3.
Welcome to Paris, home of French bread, wine, and now the Olympics. And that's how we kick off the games.
So it's a blimp that looks like bread?
No, it's real bread. It's a baguette, actually.
And how does it fly?
Let me see here. Nope.
Get the Coast TV First Alert weather app with live satellite and radar, severe weather alerts, and extended forecast. Download the free Coast TV First Alert weather app, brought to you by Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling. This is Coast TV News Today.
November 7th, 2023. Good morning, everybody. I'm Matt Pensick. Good morning, Paige.
Good morning. Thanks for joining us, everyone. I'm Paige Marley.
It is 6:28 a.m. as we make our way on a pleasant, yeah. Can I emphasize that enough?
Yeah.
A pleasant Tuesday morning.
Definitely. We love today. Great weather. Not feeling like November, but in a good way.
Yes.
Yeah, not too bad. Let's bring in First Alert meteorologist Alex Seymour. He joins us to help you prepare as you make your way out the door. Alex, they can leave those jackets at home today, though.
Yeah, certainly can leave those jackets at home. I know Matt likes this. It is going to be a Joe Nichols kind of day. Sunny and 75 as we head towards this afternoon. This morning, starting out on the mild side of things, Tone and Razor Camera at the Lewis Yacht Club. Sun is coming up. We're starting to see it get a little bit brighter out there. There are some lingering clouds blocking the sun right now, but soon these clouds are going to be moving out of here. 59 degrees right now in Lewis. Temps all across the region, upper 50s, close to 60 degrees. Currently 60 in Bethany Beach. It's 59 in Rehoboth, 54 in Ocean Pines, 58 in Millsboro, 56 degrees in Georgetown. Winds rather light, and they're going to remain rather light, 5 to 10 miles per hour for the most part, except along those back bays where we're seeing winds coming across those bays. Winds about 10 to 15 miles per hour, really not a huge issue overall. Cloud cover wise, those clouds are thinning out and going to continue to thin out throughout the next few hours. So today, the forecast is an A-plus kind of day, 75 degrees, lots of sunshine as we head towards this afternoon.
All right, thank you, Alex. Now, we do have developing news out of Milton, where the town council reviewed a report that shows the impact of rising waters and what could be done to keep the town safe.
Coast TV News reporter Charles Reinert shows us some of the options available for the community located on the banks of the Broadkill River.
Bracing for higher waters along the Broadkill River, Milton Town Council reviewed a report that looked at how sea level may impact the town in the future. The report was done by an engineering firm called Pinoni, which looked at how more flooding would impact infrastructure, Milton's roads, and more.
We are seeing sea level rise here in Delaware. It's not just on a global scale, but it's affecting everyone along the coast.
According to Pinoni, the sea level could rise by a little over a foot by 2050. The report named multiple locations near the Broadkill River that could be at risk in the future, including the Magnolia Street parking lot, the Milton Public Library, and the Milton Theater. J.P. LeCap with the theater says sea level rise is something that is thought about often.
We know that the theater is in a future flood zone. We've not had any issues in the past few years, thankfully, but it's definitely a concern that we would like to prepare for.
There were some recommendations made to town council to prepare Milton for the risk of flooding, including shoreline restoration at Memorial Park and heavier sea level rise monitoring in Milton.
Now, this report was accepted by the town council, but there was consensus that there is still a lot of work to be done to prepare for the future. I'm Charles Reinert in Milton, Coast TV News.
Happening today, Sussex County Council could make its decision regarding the appeal to a controversial proposed development in Oak Orchard. The 57-acre, 120-home development was originally denied by the Sussex County Planning Commission back in June, but the developer's attorney appealed to the council 2 weeks ago, saying this project will actually contain flooding in that area and it'll help address the high demand for housing in Sussex County.
What to do about recreational marijuana in South Bethany? This week, town is having another meeting on this issue. South Bethany officials say it will continue its look at a proposed recreational marijuana business and sale ban ordinance. At its last meeting, no action was taken and no public comment was held. The upcoming meeting is scheduled for Thursday, November 9th at 9 a.m.
Many Delaware hunting season sports are opening up this month. DenRec says openings include the popular general firearm deer season. That's also known as the shotgun season. That starts this Friday, November 10th. And DenRec says duck, Canada goose, and other hunting seasons open a little later in the month on November 20th.
In Maryland, the window is now open for loan program applications for the 2024 fiscal year. This is specifically for the State Historic Trust Program. According to the Department of Planning, a maximum of $300,000 is available. The purpose of the program is to preserve historical properties in the state. Eligible applicants include nonprofit organizations and local governments, and applications are due in January.
After leaving the Rehoboth Beach area Monday, President Biden met with Amtrak workers in Newcastle County. And this comes ahead of a speech announcing more than $16 billion in funding to approve America's busiest rail line. That taxpayer money will go to as many as 24 projects, including repairing aging bridges and tunnels in need of replacement.
Trial date has been set for 4 former Memphis police officers accused in the death of Tyree Nichols. Now, he's the man who was beaten to death after fleeing a traffic stop in January. The trial is scheduled to start August 12th of next year, and they are facing several charges, including second-degree murder. Fellow former Memphis police officer Desmond Mills may testify against them. He reached a plea deal last week. This was in a separate federal civil rights case regarding the incident. Part of that deal includes a guilty plea and testifying against the other defendants.
Former President Trump is calling for his civil fraud trial in New York to be dismissed. Trump continues to call the lawsuit an act of politically motivated election interference. Meanwhile, the Democrat attorney general bringing the suit, Letitia James, says that the evidence is on her side. The judge in the case has already found that Trump fraudulently overvalued his assets. The court is now working to determine what, if any, penalty the former president must pay.
We still got more to get to in this final half hour. Don't go anywhere.
Coming up on Coast TV News Today, now that the summer season is over, one organization is cleaning up the beaches in Ocean City. What areas they will target later this month.
Also, postseason on the pitch, a look at the Division II first round of the Delaware State High School soccer tournament that begins tonight.
And Milton looking to work with DelDOT about informing locals about flooding on Front Street and Union Street. Why this idea has some support. Stay with us on Coast TV News Today.
Crisp fall air means cool new styles and the perfect time for a run. Vernon Powell has Delmarva's largest selection of Hoka to fit your running style. Then feel the ooh in UFOS recovery footwear. Comfy Hey Dude, Birkenstock, or UGG for your whole family. Fall favorites, Patagonia flannels and North Face hoodies. Support at work with Dansko and Bionic. Wall-to-wall work boots and Carhartt apparel. Plus that expert Vernon Powell fit in Salisbury and Rehoboth Beach.
Family owned and operated since 1936.
Join Halo and Coast Country as we ring in the Christmas season with the Collingsworth family's A True Family Christmas on Thursday, November 30th at the Wicomico Youth and Civic Center. Feel the Christmas cheer as they sing family favorites along with timeless classics. Help Halo celebrate 16 years of providing service to the homeless in our community. All ticket proceeds go directly to Halo. To purchase tickets, visit haloministry.org.
Weather shapes our lives. At Coast TV, our First Alert weather team is always at work, ensuring you have the information you need.
So we're looking forward to begin to make its way towards Fenwick Island pretty quickly here.
Because we know how much weather matters to our coastal community.
Make sure you take cover from these storms.
In sunshine or storms, our promise is to guide, inform, and protect.
Make sure you are remaining weather aware tomorrow.
Weather coverage that prioritizes you. Coast TV and the First Alert weather team. Your safety, our commitment.
Let's do this. Who am I this time?
Witches!
Did not see that coming.
There's a lot at stake here.
What's the worst that could happen?
Good morning, Delmarva. Well, we are seeing an absolutely gorgeous start to the day, especially since it's early November. We shouldn't be seeing these temps in the 50s to close to 60 degrees out there this morning. And we're going to continue just to see these temps rise a good 10 to 15 degrees by this afternoon. So we're going to be, that's about 10 to 15 degrees above average, since we're already near our average high for this time of year right now. Cloud cover-wise, we're going to see those clouds continue to clear out throughout the daytime hours. Take a look at this Ocean City. We're climbing up to about 69 degrees by noon, and we're staying in the upper 60s to close to 70 degrees this afternoon. Absolutely gorgeous. Get out there. Enjoy the boardwalk in Ocean City. 71 degrees in Fenwick Island, and then in Lewis and Rehoboth Beach. 72 to 74 this afternoon. Absolutely gorgeous.
Sounds good, Alex. Thank you. Milton is asking DelDOT to install a water on roadway sign on Cave Neck Road near Front Street for use by town staff when there's flooding on Union Street and Front Street. The town council made a motion to approve this and enter a right-of-way agreement with DelDOT to allow the town to use it on the state-run road. We spoke to one person who says how beneficial this would be.
With a sign being up there a lot further before they get this far, that would be really convenient for everyone. You know, less traffic and less being lost.
Got a traffic update Laurel will tell you about. DelDOT says that Central Avenue will be closed between Market Street and Front Street beginning on Thursday, November 16th. This will be for sinkhole repair. This project will last for nearly 2 months. Work is expected to be completed on Friday, January 5th.
Delmarva Sports Network from the Wawa Studios.
Good morning, sports fans. Our game of the night will take us to the first round of the boys soccer playoffs in Delaware. Delmar faces Tower Hill in the D2 state tournament. The Wildcats have a 9-6 record. In their last outing, they defeated Seaford by 6 goals. This is a rematch of last year's first round game where Delmar lost to Tower Hill 4-0. Today, Delmar will face a Hiller squad that has shut out 10 teams this season and is 9-4-2 overall. Also in the first round of the D2 Delaware playoffs today, Indian River boys soccer is taking on Newark Charter School. Indian River is 8-4-3 overall and has earned wins over Lake Forest, Seaford, Milford, and Woodbridge this month. IR will face a Patriots squad with a 6-6-3 record, coming off a one-goal loss to St. George's Tech. To the NBA last night, the 1-4 Washington Wizards visited the 4-1 Philadelphia 76ers. Joel Embiid scored a season-high 48 points for Philly. In the third quarter, he was 10-10 from the floor and 9-9 from the foul line. Tobias Harris had 18 and De'Anthony Melton had 14 for the Sixers. Then for the Wizards, Kyle Kuzman put up 28 points and Jordan Poole had 23. The Sixers knocking off the Wizards 146-128. And today, tune in to the Delmarva Sports Network for highlights from the Delaware Division I Field Hockey State Semifinals on the final score at 10:30 p.m. That'll do it for sports. Have a great day. Entertainment news now on some movies, some music, and Broadway. Here's David Daniel with your Hollywood Minute.
Very good. Very pleased to be in America, having a great time.
Boy George is heading back to Broadway. The Culture Club singer is set to join the cast of Moulin Rouge the Musical from early February through mid-May. He'll play Harold Zidler, the owner of the Moulin Rouge nightclub. George's last Broadway appearance also involved a nightclub. 20 years ago, he wrote the music and lyrics and starred in Taboo, about the 80s London club of that name. An honor for Adele. The singer is set to receive the Sherry Lansing Leadership Award at the Hollywood Reporter's annual Women in Entertainment Gala. Lansing, a former studio exec, praises how Adele has paved the way for female artists to define their own voices and careers at a critical moment for women in music. The event is December 7th in Los Angeles.
I remember the first time I saw a screening of one sequence from Toy Story, and I remember saying, that's the end of 2D animation.
Pencils versus Pixels looks at how the traditional animation renaissance of the late 80s and early 90s was followed by the computer animation revolution, leaving 2D animators wondering about the future of their storied craft. The documentary, celebrating both types of animation and narrated by Mulan herself, Ming-Na Wen, is now available on VOD. Drawn back to Hollywood, I'm David Daniel.
Swiftie just nabbed his dream job covering all things Taylor Swift. Gannett just hired its first ever Taylor Swift reporter. His name's Brian West. Gannett Chain's vice president of local news says, quote, he has the great balance between being a veteran journalist and someone who understands everything about Taylor's world. And West says he plans to take a deep dive into Swift news, including the impact she has had on society, business, and music.
Happy Tuesday, Delmarva. Here's a look at what's happening today on Coast Life at 4 o'clock.
Hope you got your basketball shoes on because we are chatting with the Harlem Wizard.
And the holiday season is approaching. We are keeping you updated with what's going on with the Rehoboth Beach Christmas Parade.
And since it's Tuesday, we are also keeping you safe with our friends at Seaside Krav Maga in Lewis with another Get Home Safely tip.
All of that and more is happening today at 4 o'clock right here on Coast Life.
Elmer's Market, located on Route 404 in Georgetown, offers local produce, meats, seafood, and delicious baked goods. We're more than just a produce stand. Take a stroll outside to our garden center. We have perennials, shrubs, trees, and decor for the yard. Fall is here. Stop for our selection of mums and pumpkins, plus activities for the kids. If you take a picture and tag us on Facebook, you'll receive a 10% discount from us. Elmer's Market, produce, grocery, and garden, bringing you fresh, local quality at its best.
Draper Media, an equal opportunity employer, is dedicated to provide broad outreach regarding job vacancies at the station. We seek the help of local organizations in referring qualified applicants to our station. Organizations that wish to receive our vacancy information should email humanresources@wboc.com.
Yeah, we getting all fired up, getting ready for the players when they line up. Think it's time we go and get them lights up. Let them high school lights ignite us, cause we fighters coming with a hut hut like this, coming with a pick six like that. Gonna be a showdown so big, think it's time for football night to impact. High school football is everything. Hey, hey, let's go for the win, for the gold, for the crown, the ring. High school football is everything.
Watch for the IG Burton First Alert Weather Jeep.
Weather brought to you by Coastal Comfort Heating and Air Conditioning, dedicated to excellence in Delaware and Maryland.
Thank you for calling Coastal Comfort.
This is a complimentary call. A couple of years ago, I had my heat pumps replaced. Last night, I noticed one of them wasn't working right. Somebody was out here within a couple of hours, and it's working perfectly. But I was in the service industry for 33 years. Good service is something you can't find today. It very much is appreciated. Your crew is a good crew. Really fine people are professional, and they're efficient.
Coastal Comfort, a Carrier factory authorized dealer.
Carrier, turn to the experts.
It is 6:44 on this morning. It's a live look there at Seaford on our Tidal Health Cam. Surprised not many more people that we can see, at least, are out this morning because it's a great morning. Oh, there's a couple cars on school bus on their way to work, but windows down kind of morning, at least for me.
Oh, and cranking the music. That's how you roll, Paige.
Of course, always.
Hey, looking at the Coast TV weather app, one of the things I like to do each day to help me plan for what I'm going to wear, coat, heavy coat, light coat, and just got the hour-by-hour thing going. Looks like we might have to deal with some clouds, Alex, for a little bit, but overall, a pleasant day. But the thing that really stands out to me, sunset, 4:54 tonight. Oh.
Yeah, this is the worst time of year because just due to the fact that the sun sets before 5 p.m., I hate it. And we still got another 20 minutes of daylight that we lose before we start to gain anything. So, unfortunately, at least we have, well, fortunately, I should say, we at least have earlier sunrises for the next couple of weeks. But it's going to be 7:15 or later within about 2 weeks from now. But right now, the sun's already up as you take a live look out on our Boardwalk Plaza Hotel camera in Rehoboth Beach. It is an absolutely gorgeous start to the day. Temps sitting right around 59 degrees in Rehoboth Beach this morning. And we're in the 50s to close to 60 degrees all across Delmarva. It's pretty mild start to the day. 60 in Bethany Beach, it's 60 in Ocean City, 58 in Selbyville, 56 in Milton, 56 in Georgetown, 58 in Delmar. Really no complaints across the board. Winds, they are rather light coming out of the southwest. That's the most important thing. They're coming out of the south, so that is a warming wind. So we're going to see some pretty comfortable temps as we head towards this afternoon. Satellite radar picture showing clouds out there, but much thinner, much less coverage than what we were seeing just a few hours ago, and these clouds going to continue to fall apart throughout the next few hours. We're going to be looking at mostly sunny skies this afternoon. There is a cold front off to our north and west. This cold front, that is going to slide through the area overnight tonight. We're probably going to see a quick increase in the cloud cover, but not really going to make a difference. We're going to be looking at cool conditions tomorrow, but we're not going to be dealing with any wet weather. It's a dry cold front, so we don't have to worry about any rain on the way. There we go. Our in-house forecast showing southwesterly winds continuing all day long. Sunshine this afternoon. Temps in the 70s. Gorgeous. Get outside and enjoy it. As you head throughout the overnight hours, those winds with that cold front passage, they start to turn to out of the north. This is the big difference. Tomorrow morning, we're going to be about 10 to 15 degrees cooler than where we are this morning, back down into the 40s. So tomorrow morning, you probably need those light jackets again. This morning, probably don't need them. It's 50 to close to 60 degrees. So really not that bad out there. As we head towards tomorrow afternoon, it may not even get to the temperature that we are already this morning, tomorrow afternoon. Staying in the 50s to close to 60 degrees, but at least it's sunny. At least the winds are light. So really, you can get outside tomorrow, enjoy the weather. Just have that light jacket. It'll be pretty comfortable for this time of year. More clouds as we head towards Thursday morning, but that's all associated with a warm front lifting through. That warm front also not going to bring any rain, just a few extra clouds. But what it will do is bring some very warm temps back into the area. So a bit of a roller coaster ride, 75 today, 60 tomorrow, 75 again as we head towards Thursday afternoon. And then as we head towards Friday, well, we're back down. So a bit of a roller coaster ride. You drop, you rise, and you're back down. 56 on Friday, 58 degrees on Saturday. Average high this time of year, 62 degrees. So Tuesday and Thursday, good 10 to 15 degrees above average across Delmarva. So some very warm temps on the way for at least the next few days. Our Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling 7-day forecast. 75 and sunny today, 60 and sunny Wednesday, 75 and sunny on Thursday, but then a few rain showers arrive Friday, mainly early to midday. Not anything too widespread, only about a 30% chance. Temps fall down about 56 degrees, and then we stay in the 50s all weekend long.
All right, Alex, thank you so much. Buildings in Maryland are lighting up green this week. This as the Maryland Department of Veteran Affairs joins the National Association of Counties for Operation Greenlight. Homeowners are invited to light up their porches green as well. Governor Wes Moore says every day this week, state benefits for service members and veterans will be spotlighted across the state.
Operation Greenlight provides governments, businesses, organizations, and everyday folks the opportunity to learn more about military culture, about suicide prevention, and to learn from veterans about their service and their transition from the military to civilian culture.
Operation Greenlight runs through this Sunday, November 12th.
Well, coming up this month, Beach Heroes OC is organizing several cleanups throughout November. Cleanups will be held each Tuesday of the month from 9 to 10 a.m. Cleanup locations in Ocean City include 4th Street on November 7th, North Division Street on the 14th, Somerset Street on November 21st, and the Inlet on the 28th.
And coming up this weekend, a cleanup for the Gordon Pond Trail on Saturday, November 11th. The Friends of Cape Henlopen State Park will hold a cleanup. This will focus on clearing brush and trash along the Gordon Pond Trail. Volunteers are asked to report at 8:45 a.m. to the pavilion at Rehoboth at the end of that trail.
A new website's been launched by Southern Delaware Tourism. It's called Culinary Coast. It's a site we're going to show you here. The website aims to promote more of the food attractions of the Delaware coastal area. This includes restaurants and distillery listings, culinary events, farmers markets, and local specialties. It also showcases a blog that features guest posts.
It's now 6:50 this morning. Time to check in with our coastal pet of the day, brought to you by Maggie's Pet Boutique.
And this good boy on your screen right now is named Hank. And as you can see, Hank's a very simple dog. He has no problem sitting for a cute picture on a bright, sunny day. Hank loves to walk on the beach and tries to do so any chance he gets. Hank lives in Lewis, and this was sent to us by Penelope.
Adorable. We want to keep seeing those photos of your pets, so send us pictures. Tell us what makes your pets so special.
Right. You can email us at content@coasttvnews.com, and then watch weekdays like you're doing right now from 5 to 7 a.m. to see all of the pets we feature.
Well, gorgeous weather continues for a few more days this week. I'll have a final check on your first alert weather forecast coming up in just a few minutes.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Enjoy 10 songs in a row, brought to you by Pohanka of Salisbury.
For a great shopping experience, Furniture Gallery is the place to pick up one-of-a-kind signature finds to complete your home decor. Come explore our selection of handcrafted furniture and get all the supplies you need for your own DIY projects. And through the doors is Shaw Marketplace, where you'll find the most unique local shops at the beach. With over 40 local artisans, Shaw Marketplace is truly a local connection you cannot afford to miss. And next door you'll find Scrub Apparel Outlets. All this under one roof with easy access off Coastal Highway North.
Shop with Steve Mons. Weekday mornings, 6 till 10. Big 107.7.
Chesapeake Healthcare is always growing, adding providers, including a new head of dentistry, expanding our mental health care to the Crisis Center in Berlin, and adding accolades. Several of our providers are Stars of Salisbury Award winners and finalists, as well as Best Local Pharmacy and Best Local Business. That's because Chesapeake Healthcare's office staff handles all the billing and insurance work, so our doctors have time to be doctors. Learn more at ChesapeakeHC.org. Wall to wall, and I still ain't sold out.
Wall to wall, and I still ain't sold out. One step closer, can you hear us now? Victorious. Oh. How do you feel the sun without me?
Delmarva's rock station for 35 years.
Jesse L. Martin is back.
You're the science guy.
That's Bill Nye. I'm actually the behavioral science guy.
And he has people talking.
It really helped the Rams win the Super Bowl?
It was a risky experiment, but it worked out for them.
The Irrational, Monday on NBC and streaming on Peacock.
It is 6:54. It's time now for some things you need to know before you go. Today, Sussex County Council could make a call on the appeal to the proposed development in Oak Orchard. The 57-acre, 120-home development was originally denied by the Sussex County Planning Commission in June. But the developer's attorney appealed to the council 2 weeks ago, saying this project could actually curb flooding in that area and help address the high demand for housing in Sussex County.
Next town to discuss marijuana is South Bethany. It is having its second marijuana meeting this week. It says it will readdress the recreational marijuana business and sale ban ordinance. At its last meeting, no action was taken and no public comment was held.
Crews worked to clean up vandalized gates at the White House following a weekend of protests. Some pro-Palestinian attendees opted to damage buildings and vandalize the White House. Protesters laced statues and gates with anti-Semitic graffiti as they marched toward the White House demanding a ceasefire in Gaza. Some there even tried to climb the White House gate.
Work is underway for the construction of a new police station in Millsboro. This is on Railroad Avenue and Ellis Street. The new station will be about 13,000 square feet. It more than doubles the size of the current station. It will have a private office for its victim services advocate, also larger officers' quarters and more. Chief Calloway there says he expects the department to move into the new station on January 1st of 2024.
All right, are you looking to update your travel bucket list?
Yeah, a little bit, Paige.
Definitely am, yeah. National Geographic's cool list has lots of places that could be worth your while.
Okay, so in the United States, the entire states of New York and Texas made the cut.
All right, about half of the 30 places on that list, they're in Europe. Not a big surprise there.
Yeah, some other cool spots include Lima, Peru, and Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula. I have not been to either of those places. I do have a place on the bucket list, though,
what
Paige.
Is it?
It's Key West, Florida.
Ah,
wanted to go there.
Key West.
It's never happened, but it is on the bucket list.
Okay, that's a good one, too. My favorite place I've visited is Haiti.
Okay.
Very beautiful views, the good people there. I don't think I have anything on the bucket list, though.
Oh, okay.
I'll go anywhere. I'll go with you to Key West.
That'll be great.
All right.
Margaritaville and all that.
Oh, yes, definitely. Sounds good. All right. Hey, it's 6:56 now, and I want to ask Alex Seymour, where do you want to go, Alex, to travel bucket list?
You know, my favorite place that I've ever been is Italy, and I'd probably go back. That would certainly be it. The Amalfi Coast, I didn't get to go there. We went to Rome and Venice. I could go back to Venice. I could live in Venice. It was absolutely gorgeous there.
I bet.
All right. So here on Delmarva, we've got some gorgeous weather on the way for the next few days before we see some cooler temps finally start to move in. Right now, Hershey Exteriors camera at the 45th Street Tap House in Ocean City. Pretty quiet this morning. Temp sitting right around 55 degrees. We're going to be climbing up into the mid-70s this afternoon, 75 degrees. And then our Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling 10-day forecast shows some up and down temperatures over the next few days, down to 60 tomorrow for that high, but back up to 75 by Thursday. Once we get into the weekend, though, the 50s, they return, overnight lows in the 30s, and then we're going to stay with those cooler conditions all throughout the weekend, then especially as we head towards the beginning of next week. So it will start to feel more like November as we head closer to the weekend.
Sounds good, Alex. Thank you so much, and thank you for joining us on Coast TV News Today.
And the Today Show is coming up next at 7 a.m.
We'll be back with Coast TV News Midday at 11, so stick around.
And for even more news, coverage you can count on, go ahead, grab your phones, and download the Coast TV News and Weather apps. Have a great Tuesday morning, everybody.